want to be. Change the world.
I promise I would never go back to being that person.
But when somebody does something unspeakable, it's
when you hardly knew them.
You do something about it, because you can.
I mean about a girl.
16 seconds.
You do not flinch. In this entire movie, you've got explosions and guns. You never flinch.
Well, that's because Antoine used the takes where I didn't.
Does he flinch?
I'm sure we all do.
Not that often, but you know.
Does anything unnerve you, though? What unnerves you in real life?
Me, personally?
Yeah, you personally.
First of all, this is a movie.
I know that.
It's not real life. So,
oh!
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So things,
you got me.
Yeah, that's natural. That's right. Not. There's nothing wrong with that. That same thing would have happened to me. But this is a movie. It's a controlled reality. You jumped, though.
Jeez, it's you.
Yo, Pop, bet you didn't have to push no dollies at your old job, did you?
Guilty as charged.
You're getting up there. You're called Pops by one of the characters. I mean, a couple times.
I'm getting up there or the character?
Well, since you're playing the guy, both of you, I guess.
Well,
do you find those comments funny? Do you like the ribbing occasionally? Pops, getting older.
I'm in a position to take it out of the script if I wanted to, so no, it didn't bother me. That's a part of it. And who said it? I know who said it.
The guy,
they're 17.
Yeah,
you know,
17.
To them, they're 30. Ooh, that's the old people.
Yeah, you get Pops when you're 26.
Yeah, 17. I'm telling you.
When you're scripting and choreographing the different scenes, do you factor in that there are things that maybe he can't do?
No,
not at all. Same stuff, doesn't change
at all. He boxed for 20 years. I go to the gym, same gym. In fact, his trainer now trains me. He goes more around boxing than I go. So no, that's not even a thought. Yeah. I just read it and go, okay, and we talk about if he likes what it is for the story, then we do it, if it works.
Not enough? Because I can keep going, brick by brick, dollar by dollar. Body by body.
Your guy's character name is Teddy.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds very sweet. Not so much.
Well, he's vulnerable in his own way. He's vulnerable on the inside, but he puts out lots of defenses, you know. But inside, if you got to know him, you'd like him,
for
sure. Yeah, it just takes a bit of time.
Yeah, how much time?
It depends.
Couple
yeah, if he wanted something from you, it wouldn't take very long.
There are several great scenes with you two, but the one in the restaurant where you're just toe-to-toe, and it's intense. You've acted with some great guys before, but what's it like sitting across a table from him?
It's very rewarding. I got to see close up what he was doing, and I had a really good time doing it. We did quite a few takes of that scene, and I learned a lot. You know, Denzel is very methodical, very precise. And in such close proximity, and you get to know somebody. And what was beautiful about working with him is that you're grounded in each other as the actor, and then there's the character. And it was a pleasure. It was an honor, you know. And then he would change things, and I go, oh, okay. You can kind of see why he would change it and how he'd move in. He'd take it kind of slow to begin with, and then come up with an idea, and then build around that idea, and then move to another one, and layer it, and then he'd turn on the fire, and he'd go, whoa, okay, this is good. And
I have no feelings about you, one way or the other. You're like lint or a bottle cap. You're just a thing to remove.
It's one thing to insult Denzel, but you called him lint. You called him lint. Uh-huh. That's pretty low. Your character calls him lint.
It was about a lot of things, but the way I read it was that from Teddy's perspective, it was a genuine comment. It was about removing something that was unnecessary, and it says more about Teddy's disposition towards any kind of emotion about something. I don't care about, Teddy didn't care about him, and was saying it. It was very genuine. He was being friendly in many respects. He was being honest. He was being, like, this is, I got to tell you this. This is what I think of you. And for Teddy, it's just a detachment. It's like...
See the softer side of Teddy. He meant well,
that's
even
right.
With that comment.
That's right. Well, he would think as much. Yeah, so I think we're onto something here.
I promised someone that I love very much that I would never go back to being that person.
Nah. How's he changed since training day?
Well, we all changed and evolved, you know? How he changed, I don't, he's same Denzel to me, doing what he does.
We're too busy making a movie to be worrying about,
What is wrong with Antoine today? He's changed. Yeah, let me go back and look at my old footage.
He has Nikes instead of the Adidas today. What's going on?
Who knows?
What I loved about this movie is I've never seen a movie where I knew less about the main character and wanted to know so much more.
Good.
So it leaves you really hoping there are more in the works.
Yeah, we'll see.
When do you wait to make that decision?
The audience makes that decision.
Yeah, audience.
It's not what we want, it's what they want.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, people have to go. If they say they want more, we give them more.
Do you go to a theater opening weekend? Do you watch the movie that week in a theater?
No.
You don't?
No. I don't go to the theater, period.
Ever?
No.
Just for fun? Get some
popcorn? You mean of my own movies?
Just in general.
No. No, I don't go to the movies. I don't go to the theater to see my own movies. I mean, I watched it, so I know what I'm talking about today.
Right.
But no, the last time I was doing, it was Malcolm X. So it was early 91, 92. I was in Philadelphia, so I might have been working on Philadelphia, the movie. And we were near a theater, and I was like, oh, Malcolm X was playing. So I went in for a minute just to hear the reactions. But no, I don't sneak in. It's too late then.
You ever go to Home Depot?
Home Mart.
I know it's Home Mart, but it looks like
It looks like a Walmart, like a Kmart, like a Home Depot.
It's a Mart.
True value.
What do you see when you look at me?
It's too late to start over.